Hello everyone and welcome. Today I'm going to show you my Galaxy Eyes Dick profile. I'm very excited to show you what this dick does. I'm going to explain its function, win conditions and pros and cons. And if you like the video, like and subscribe because it will help me to improve this deck more and play it at a regional or even a YCS and show the world that Galaxy Eyes are a strong rogue deck. And let's begin. So, if you want to play Galaxy Eyes, Galaxy Eyes are an anime deck from Yu-Gi-Oh! Zexal. It's based around Galaxy, Photon and Galaxy Eyes monsters, three archetypes that work really good in combination. You can't play one without the other. The deck focuses on level 8 and level 4 monsters that make rank 4 and rank 8 Xyz monsters. And it's very potent in OTKing, housing the one of the strongest monsters in terms of attack power gain. It can achieve, if you combine it with other cards in the deck and it's very consistent, you can achieve 15 or 20,000 damage depending on the board. Most likely around 12,000. And it houses its upgraded form Chaos number 62 Neo Galaxy Eyes Prime Photon Dragon, which is the absolute strongest monster in the game in terms of dealing the most amount of raw damage to the opponent. It can achieve around 12,800 damage and it can attack 3 times while being unaffected by monsters. It achieves around 30,000 damage in one turn if the opponent has attack position monsters, so no other monster can beat that. Recently, Tempai Dragon can achieve a lot of damage, but they can achieve the whole engine, not a single monster. So he's the strongest monster in the game in terms of damage. So to begin, I played two Galaxy Eyes Photon Dragon, the key card in the deck. As you can see, I played two. That might surprise you. You can do the combo with two. This is the minimum amount. 3 is really nice to get one of the punishes from the spell, but 2 is sufficient enough, so you can even recycle it in OTK on the follow-up turn. So this reduces the chance you have to brick, because this deck plays a lot of level 8, and I have optimized it like a hybrid build, so you can play first and second with the most win rate as possible, not just gas going first and lose second, because this deck can OTK really well, and it even OTKs so well that you can choose to play as a blind second deck. But with the most recent cards revealed, like the Photon Delta Wing and the Prosperity included in the deck profile, the consistency goes up by a lot and you can play first and going second cards and achieve both the best of the both worlds, playing first and second. So you only play two, then you play the one Afterglow Dragon. This is the neighbor for the OTK because it's doubles the attack of the number monsters while detached, then summon Galaxy Eyes. It's part of the combo, it's part of the OTK, one of the most important cards. You play one Photon Emperor, he enables the second normal summon. One Galaxy Brave, he's part of the combo for summoning the Harbinger and the Lord plus the Link, because you target the Emperor with Trance and summon him from the deck. I will explain side patterns in another video, but you basically can cut him going second. Then I will play 3 Galaxy Wizard. He is the main searcher and quote unquote starter in the deck. This deck performs really well with 2 card combos. Only Foolish Burial is a 1 card combo, and he plus a lot of other cards makes the full board. So he's really good for the combo, and he's played at 3 in my opinion. He can even dodge Skill Drain if it happens to be flipped upon you, because he sends himself as a cost to the graveyard and activates to activate his effect to search. So he's really good in that regard. So then I play 3 Galaxy Soldier. He's really important in the deck because he can search Wizard and discard card, and can discard cards from the hand to the graveyard. You can discard him if he's in your hand and you bricked, or even Galaxy Eyes, but if you play two copies, it's a little tricky if you discard with Galaxy Soldier. If you play three, no worries. But the best card to discard with Soldier would be the Photon Jumper, which I played two copies of him. He can be played at 3, but I have narrowed down the list to the most optimal numbers, and I think 2 is enough. His effect is when he is sent to the graveyard to search a spell or a trap, and this deck houses one of the most strong spell cards, power spells which enable the OTKs and the combo, so he can search him. And the second effect is not too bad to evade the battle phase when an attack is declared, so he's a really good card and one of the most important reasons why this deck can compete with the meta is the Photon Jumper. Then I play 3 Photon Delta Wing. So Delta Wing is really interesting, most people don't like him, but I think he's a really good starter in the deck, so you can complement the other non-engine you play and see an engine card to play. Unfortunately, he alone can't achieve much in terms of the full board, and even with the second card he achieves half board, so he is like a follow-up card, or if you break and you have another card, you can achieve like a semi board. But most annoying thing about him is that he requires two other cards to play, so he is a 3 card combo, not a 2 card, but it helps a lot with the consistency, so you don't mind that and you play 3 copies. Then I play 3 copies of Photon Orbital. Don't worry guys, I will get the secret rare Orbital soon, and max the rarity of my deck to almost full potential. So the reason you play Orbital is because he can search everyone of them and can even protect your monsters by battle when he's attached to a monster. This becomes relevant in some stun matchups like Eldritch, for example, or some other shenanigans. He can protect you from battle and like you survive a turn more to hopefully break the lock. And the really interesting part is he isn't once per turn to activate from the hand to equip. So in a weird way, I have had a game that the enemy summoned Light and Darkness Dragon, which is a mandatory negate, and I just chained our Photon Orbital over and over until he ran out of negates. So Orbital is a instant win against Light and Darkness Dragon, especially now that this card has gained popularity because of the Horus engine. So yeah, he's really cool. Then I play the one Photon Vanisher and the one Galaxy Summoner. They are essential to the combo, you don't need more than one here because I play only 2 Galaxy Eyes Photon Dragon on the original, he searches it. But Summoner is required to loop Galaxy's Wizard because he is not once per turn, and he can reduce the level of Galaxy Soldier to level 4, so you can exceed. He is mandatory in the combo and he is good, really good as well, especially if the enemy has hand traps, he can extend really well into them. Then for the hand traps of the deck, so these are proxies because I don't have my ashes right now, but essentially you play 3 ashes. Don't mind the proxies, don't worry, I don't play in them in real tournaments. This is all for the like actual hand traps monsters. Then I play the consistency spells. Galaxy 100, this is a really good spell card, it's a foolish burial for Photon and Galaxy monsters, and you have 2 targets, the Jumper and the Emperor. It even punishes a card from their extra deck like Unicorn, so this card is really really essential against any fusion deck that plays Super Bowl. You punish Mudima Dragon and they count out the Link plus the Lord. Only the Link plus the Hope Harbinger with the Garura, but the Lord is really strong card because he can search follow up and gain monster effects. You mitigate a lot of their potential for breaking your board if you banish the Mud Dragon, and against other matchups you can banish cards that are problematic like Zeus, Typhon, SP, you can banish the one of requirements, for example, against Tri Brigade, you can banish if they play one Shurik, or again, against some other decks, you can banish the Princess. Also, you can banish one relinquished anima, and you can achieve one banish on your turn and one banish on the enemy turn with certain combos. So this card is really good in certain matchups and is definitely required for the engine to run as a semi-starter. You can also pair this with Galaxy Soldier and a lot of other cards to achieve 2-card combos, which I will show you later. Then I play the 3 Pot of Prosperity. This is self-explanatory. The only annoying thing is that your extra deck is really tight and you can't afford to punish certain cards. So you almost always banish for 3, and in rare circumstances you banish for 6. But it helps a lot because sometimes your hands brick and Pot of Prosperity saves them because you acquire one of the 3 cards you excavate. And in certain combos you need specific cards, so the deck is not like every 2 cards work. Like for example, Aina Raid Raptors work when you need 2 level 4s. You need specific combinations and there are a lot of combos which are really difficult, but yeah, Pot of Prosperity helps out. Also these are proxies, so don't mind me. Then for the power spells I have the one Galaxy Trance, which is a 1 card OTK, and it helps with the board. 1 Galaxy Expedition, and I really like this card, it's essential. 1 Numbers Last Hope, which always counts as a Galaxy card. It helps on the follow-up to OTK. You surge this with Lord if you have Galaxy Ice Proton Dragon in hand for the link. So this card is mandatory because it helps OTK second. It can be bricky, but if you set up your graveyard right, you can literally play through Nibiru or go for the OTK through a lot of interruptions, and it helps from the follow-up, so this card is amazing. So then for the other one was that you can play to boost the consistency is 1 Foolish Burial and 1 Reinforcements of the Army or Rota. So they help, this one can serve Photon Jumper to pair with Soldier, so essentially is one more copy of Jumper, but it can also search Photon Vanisher who can special summon himself, so I think it's a good thing to have them. So these are the consistency cards. Then I play 3 copies of Forbidden Droplet, and I think in the main deck it's really good. It can stop Centurion Calamity Lock, it can break certain ports. Against Stun decks it's nice because you can out Skill Drain with the Droplet. So you summon Full Armor Photon Dragon and activate his effect to pop the Skill Drain and chain the Droplet and it send the Photon Dragon to the graveyard, so his effect can resolve to pop the Skill Drain, and the Droplet can go through the negated effect of the Skill Drain because it reduces the attack first, then negates the effect, so you can use it under Skill Drain. It's really nice against combo decks. It outs certain lock monsters like Winda, Bakuska, Plasma, and in some matchups like against stun decks like Jaugan, it reduces the attack, it breaks boards, it stops Appaloosa, Baron, Dispatter. It also helps make your engine work because you need a lot of cards in the graveyard and some effects activate from the graveyard. So second, as you have 6 cards, this card is really nice to make your combo and engine work. So it starts the combo, and you can even dodge sending the monsters from the field to the graveyard to dodge something like Imperm. So it's really nice there. And this card can also make a lot of other tricks that are really strong. So next I play 3 Triple Tactics Talent. So this card helps if you go first and they hand trap you to draw 2, or look at their hand if you have a 3 card a two-card combo and an extender. You can play through one hand trap if it's not in perm. And the three copies of talents ensure you that you can draw two if you brick. And if you still have the combo, you can look their hand and discard Nibiru, for example, and still make the combo, or you can draw two and play through, let's say, another hand trap. So it's good going second as well. Most of the time I side it against certain matchups, but I think it's really good as a board breaker spell card. And the last three board breaker / hand trap cards I play is three permanent, because it plays around talents, and talents right now is, I think it's a strong card in the meta, so I play around it with imperm, because sometimes it can hurt if they see your hand and shuffle one of your starters, and it can break my board because they can steal the Lord and make Zeus or Typhoon and even negate with the monster effect, and it's really annoying against my board, so I play imperm to mitigate that. So this is the main deck. In total, I play 3 Ash, 3 Droplet, 3 Triple Tactic Talent, and 3 Imperm, which are 12 hand traps or / board breakers, which I think are really good in the meta right now. Against Fire King, you side out the Ash, but it can help the first game. Imperm also helps. I find that I can break an extent of their board with Droplet and talents, and with certain hands, and if they mess up, I can OTK through the Fire King board. It discard also, Droplet also helps against Voiceless and against almost every rogue deck. So I think this lineup is good. You can always just change it depending on your likings and your preferred cards. But I play this 12. Now it's the time for the extra deck. So we play one number 62 Galaxy Ice Prime Photon Dragon, and then the upgraded version, one Chaos number new Galaxy Ice Prime Photon Dragon. He is the strongest monster in the deck, the boss monster. You OTK with him a lot. He can achieve 12k attack and attack 3 times. Also, he is unaffected by monsters. In almost all circumstances you summon him, but in rare circumstances when you need to achieve a higher attack damage or the enemy has Ash, you can OTK with the blue one, because he activate his effect in the damage step, and after Glow Dragon can be Ashed when he special summons or attaches the original Galaxy Ice. So they can't Ash in the damage step, where if you OTK with the red one, he does his thing to detach and double the attack in the start of the battle phase. So if you know the enemy has Ash, you should go for the blue one, but almost always the red one is perfect. You can always OTK through Nibiru. So for example, if this is your fifth summon and he has the correct materials, which are the original Galaxy Ice and after Glow Dragon, he can survive the Nibiru because he's an effective or he's a material. And then you can, instead of attaching him, you can special summon Galaxy Ice and remove the Nibiru with Galaxy Ice, and then he will attack directly for 11,200. So you can OTK to Nibiru if he is your fifth summon. He is the main win condition of the deck. Then we play the one number 90 Galaxy Ice Photon Lord. He is one of the strongest monsters in the deck also. He can negate monsters, he can destroy them if you detach a galaxy material, he can protect himself if he has a photon card as a material, and he can add or attach a card from the deck to your hand. Not just a simple negate like all other deck level 8 spam decks splash him and literally steal our monster. He's literally 4 times stronger in the deck. He can surge, destroy, protect himself and attach a material, so in a long game he can always replenish, not just to negate. And he can trigger the effects of the Galaxy Ice, so he's a must, and he's almost always made when you're going first. The other strong monster is Hope Harbinger. Hope Harbinger is a spell negate and can your attacks into him. so he can protect the link. Next is one full armor Photon Dragon. He outs spell or traps or face up problematic card. You can make him on top of any Galaxy Eyes Xyz monster and you detach a material and top a card face up in the field. Okay, so the next card which you play is one Galaxy Eyes Cypher Dragon. He has a change of heart like effect. You detach a material target monster on the enemy field and take control of it. The monster attack becomes 3000 and his name is Galaxy Eyes Cypher Dragon. So that's kinda relevant because of the other two Cypher Xyz monsters. But keep in mind you cannot attack directly except with him the turn you activate his effect. So if you Xyz over him, you can't kill your opponent if you defeat all his monsters. That might screw you up in some games. But he is really good to break ward, especially equipped with the other. So you can make him, then him, steal a monster, pop a face up card, and then make Galaxy Eyes Cypher Blade on top of them to pop a face down card. He's the same effect as the Armored Dragon, but he can pop face down cards as well. So he's really good. You cannot exceed over him, so that's another thing. And you remove 3 cards from the board from that combo. You can also make Galaxy Eyes Cypher Hicks, which is part of the combo. You make him with with Afterglow and Emperor and detach both to protect all your light monsters from targeting until the end of the opponent's turn. So they become all untargetable and you cannot imperm, for example, the Lord. So he will be pretty, it's a really strong effect. He's part of the first turn combo. Sometimes you make him second to protect your cards from being targeted when you OTK with the Neo Prime. So he's really good. Also, you can make him on top of the stolen monster you got from the Cypher Dragon. If it's a normal effect monster, he will not be able to use his effect because it's a one material. But if you steal an Xyz monster, you can overlay him on top of that monster. He can use that effect depending on the Xyz monster he's a material. You can also make the monster into Zeus. It retains the attribute, it doesn't become light, so you can't link it, but you can Xyz into the Cypher Hex. So he's really nice. Then we have the rank 4s, and there are two rank 4 Galaxy Photon Dragon, the main searcher of the deck. He searches any Photon or Galaxy card or dumps it in the graveyard. So you can trigger Jumper, Emperor, get the Galaxy 100 or the Power Spells, the Photon Vanisher, everything. He's so good. And he can make one of your monsters level 8 when he's special, when the monster is special. So for example, he can make the Vanisher level 8 or the Galaxy Soldier from 5 to 4 or 8. Then you have one Galaxy Photon Blast. He protects everything from targeting and destruction. If the monster has 2000 or more attack, he himself is not protected because he's at 1800. But you can pair him with the Galaxy Photon Dragon, which boosts all other light monsters by 500 attacks. So both these monsters form a mini lock where the enemy can't target and destroy any of your monsters with 2000 or more attack. And he can also summon a photon monster from the hand on summon, and as a quick effect on your opponent's turn, resurrect one of your Galaxy Eyes monsters from the grave or banish pile. So he can resurrect it from the banish pile and trigger the Galaxy Hunt on enemy turn a second time, which in turn will banish a card from their extra deck. So he's awesome. Next up, you play one Bakuska. If they lock you in some circumstances, he can delay the duel by one turn, or if you get shifter, draw or whatever, and then in the follow-up you can play all your cards and OTK with him.
So Baguska is Riku. One Zeus, he's a light. Delta Wing locks you into light, so you can summon Delta Wing and another Delta Wing in form Baguska. But you can still make Zeus because he's a light. And you can't make Bolt if you lock yourself with the Galaxy Trance, so keep that in mind. But Zeus is really nice in some boards. You can make Baguska with 2 force. He is untargetable while in attack. You can attack and then make Zeus with 3 materials, unfortunately. But you can make Zeus. So the untargetable Baguska is really nice in attack, and you can out a lot of boards that. So, because if you summon this rank 4, he can be, for example, targeted and destroyed. But if you summon Baguska, they can't target destroyed. You can attack and then make Zeus. And then if they target it to destroy, you can chain and wipe the board. And if you have, for example, protection from him, they can't target even Zeus because he is a light, and then wipe the board again. So, Zeus for an easy. And then the last 2 cards are the 2 Link monsters, Galaxy Eyes Soulflare Dragon. He is part of the first turn board because when he's on the field during the opponent's turn main phase, you can discard him, only him, and pop a special summon monster, or you can discard both 1 Galaxy and 1 Photon card and achieve the same. So in some circumstances that comes up, but most often you will search him with the Lord or Vanisher on your turn and have one Galaxy Eyes in hand to pop the enemy monster. And when he is summoned, he targets one monster in your graveyard and adds it back into your hand, so he can reoccur resources. You can also make him with any of your monsters and Nibiru, and the Nibiru token, because he requires 2 lights and the Nibiru token is light. So in some cases you can play around under Nibiru. Your board gets wiped and you can still make with the monster and the token. So you can play after the Nibiru's effect resolves with him. And he is part of the first turn combo. So that's the extra deck. It's 15 cards. You almost can't cut anything. I see some lists with 1 Galaxy Photon, but usually you punish him and these 2 for the prosperity, and you combo with the other one. And for the side deck, you play mandatory, in my opinion, either Judgment or Tachyon Transmigration. It's not searchable, but you can negate the problematic cards like Evenly Dark or Droplet or Talents when you're first. So either Judgment or this is mandatory for the deck for a going first card. It's really strong if you negate 2 things, because it shuffles them into the deck and negates everything under the chain. But only activation of spell and traps. So for example, if it's an already face up field spell that activating its effect after being activated, you can't negate the effect. If the field spell activates its effect, for example, to search on the activation of the physical card, then you can negate it. If it's already face up on the field and activates as a ignition effect, you can't negate it because it negates activation of cards, not effects for the spell and traps. So yeah, but this card is like one of the strongest counter traps in the game. Then I played 3D Barrier. So this card I played only because in my regionals there are a lot of branded players. And this card stops branded. There are also branded Chimera and no other branded variants. So yeah, I play this only for branded, and it can help against some other matchups. But overall, if you don't have that kind of meta, you can cut it and play other 3 cards. For example, other 3 going first cards. This deck is nice with Gozen Match, I think, because it locks into 1 attribute and all your attributes are light. But right now it's not good in the meta because of the all the fire stuff. So you can play, for example, summon limit, but then you can't OTK on the follow-up, and anti-spell kills the deck because you play all these spell cards. So I don't recommend using those, and you might think of some other hand trap But I play the Libera then. The other mandatory stuff in my opinion is the back row removal to Lanthisome Swan Harpy and the 3 Cosmic. So these are for floodgates when you go second, summon limit, anti-spell, some field spells in like for example Runic, you can punish in the Snake Eyes matchup IP when they resurrect it, you can punish the field spell to not resurrect it, you can lure out branded cards, you can stop some like flu field spells or some other things like Kashtira with the field spell. But most importantly this is for the floodgates, and because this deck has a really hard matchup against trap decks, you play all the back row removal. So you play all this back row removal only for the trap decks, only for the stun and trap decks, so this out and some stun variants as well. So I think overall for the side deck of the Galaxy Eyes, this 9 are 100% mandatory. These are for first to not lose to like everything post side, and these are the for the hard matchups and to out like everything post side. So these are the 9 cards. These are changeable, and I play 3 Nibiru or 3 Draw and Lock. For example, you can play 3 Veil or Bell or whatever. These 6 are the like slots you can interchange with whatever you like and feel for the meta, but right now I think these 9 are 100% mandatory, and these 6 you can change what in whatever you like. So that's for the side deck.